This is the dumbest bunch of crap I ever saw. Oh my God. Like, they even care if we show up on time, really. Oh, dang it. Thank you for calling IDEA. This is Sybil. How may I help you? Okay, wait. Stop. Alright, I'm going to need either... Can you give me a minute? I know you're upset. Look, I can't help it if you don't read the instructions, okay? Put out the fire. There's a literal fire. Okay, we'll deal with that and call me back, okay? Something on fire. I don't know what you need to do about it. Oh my God. Thank you for calling IDEA. This is Sybil. How may I help you? Yes, sir. Yes. Okay, like, we're like the last line of defense for people who just can't read directions. That's why our number is on the paper. So I'm assuming that you finally got out the directions. Like, after you tried to do it without the directions and then you saw our number. Because we don't freely give this number out. Okay, first of all, is there a problem with your actual account? Like, are they after you or something? Okay, you're having trouble putting it together. Oh, that's not necessary. If you just need some help with assembly instructions, I might be able to do that. And tell me what item it is that you have. Wait. Stop. Don't even try to pronounce it. Just don't. Just don't. Okay. Now I need... Well, that's what we're trying to figure out, sir. I mean, I know you can tell me what it is, but, like, we need to actually know the name of your product. Okay? The Leedle Doodle Laddle? I seriously doubt it. No, if you have the medium-sized Allen wrench, that is not the item you mean. The Killeedle Doodle? No, sweetie, that's a coffee table. It doesn't have shelves. You said you had shelves in a drawer. I think what you mean is the Laddle Cadoodle. Does that sound right? Never mind about the little dots over some of the letters. Don't worry about the little... I know it looks like some of them have V's over them. Let's not worry about that. Are you talking about the Laddle Cadoodle? Alright, fine. Let me pull up the instructions for that. Just give me a minute. Well, no, sir, I'm not Rain Man. I don't have all that readily available, like, a half a second after you call. Just give me one hot second. Now, we have two types of Laddle Cadoodles here. We have the regular, which has, it looks like it has two shelves. And then, like, double opening cabinet doors. And then the deluxe has four opening cabinet doors. Do you have the two or the four? The two. I guess you're too cheap to get the four. All right, now listen to me. How far have you gotten with your assembly? You lost one of the bags of pieces. Okay, sir, I'm assuming that you took everything out and you laid it out on the floor. How did you lose an entire bag of pieces? Well, I don't know if the dog ate them or not, sir. I don't really know what you expect me to do from here, because I'd be willing to bet I'm at least 1,000 miles away from you right now. Okay, well, what you're going to have to do... Oh, listen. Don't get mad at me. It's not my fault. What I'm going to do, I'm going to give you another number that you're going to have to call. Yes, sir, because you're going to have to order some more pieces. No, we do not replace those for free. It is not our fault that you lost them. Now, if you had received the package and the pieces simply weren't there, that would be another matter. But you've already admitted to me that you lost them. You had them, and now you don't. That is officially not our problem. No, the customer's not always right. Okay, do you want the other pieces or not? Because without my phone number, you're not going to get them. Unless you want to go buy a whole other kit just for that little baggie of parts. It's up to you. Well, listen now. Are you going to write this down? Don't make me repeat it like 5 times. Are you ready to write it down? Don't say you're ready if you're not. Okay? Here we go. 1-800. IMALOSER. And see, then you just spell it out on your keypad. You just pick the numbers that correspond to those letters. 1-800-IMALOSER. And that will get you the parts that you need, okay? Well, until you get the parts, I don't really see a reason for us to stay on the phone, because, like, you're going to get part of the way into it, and then you're going to need the parts that were in that bag, and you're not going to have them. So, at this point, there's really not much more I can do for you. I mean, I don't think, unless you just want me to commiserate with you and tell you I'm really sorry, and this sucks and stuff, and, like, I don't know, keep an eye on your dog, like, maybe he did swallow them. I don't know. I mean, life is unfair sometimes, sir. Okay, well, you do too. Thank you. Yes, thank you for choosing IDEA. This is Sybil. How may I help you? I will be glad to help you with that. Yes, I understand your frustration. Oh, it's perfectly fine. Usually by the time people call me, they're very frustrated, and it's entirely okay. Okay, stop crying. Okay, it's gonna be all right. No, I promise you, your marriage is not over. Okay, well, you both just need to take a breath, step away from the kit, okay? Step away from the unassembled stuff, whatever it is you have. Okay. Do you have me on speakerphone right now? Okay, no, I don't care. All right. And here's what we're gonna do. Is your only problem assembly? You have an invoice problem as well. I don't normally handle that, but I can take a quick look if you like. Do you have your account number? Did you say 42? Okay. Alright. Wait a minute, give me that again. Can you give me that number one more time? No, because I'm getting some really funky name, and you just don't sound like that name fits. Can I have that again? Oh, is the account in your name? Okay, I'm sorry. Sorry, start over. I'm sorry, I'm still not getting anything. How about you just give me your name? Start with your last name. And your first name? Zoe. So that would be Z-O-E. No. Oh, no, honey, I didn't spell your name wrong. Your parents did. Can you spell that again? Z-O-O-I-E-Y? Are you serious? Oh, and the first O has the dots over it. Okay. Do you know what those dots are called? How old are you? 27. You're 27, and you've had this funky name with those dots over the O all this time, and you don't know what they're called. You might want to check on that. That just makes you look really stupid. Okay, you had your account number way wrong. I don't know where you got that number from, but it's completely wrong. Okay, now what are you saying is the problem? I don't see that. No, you bought some manchette and canopkas about 4 months ago. And a clatter bugle back in December of 2015. Well, I don't even have on here that you bought anything recently. So who paid for this kit that you have now? Did you steal it? Your boyfriend did. If you bought it on your boyfriend's account, why did you give me your information? Because that is totally useless. Okay, we'll just have him call back. Okay, we've already spent enough time on this. Let's just move on to something productive. What's your problem with the kit? Okay, hold on a second. A Bjornblad? Those are closet door hooks, sweetheart. Bjornblad? Blamjad? That's an earwax disposal kit. Hold on, you know what? Just spell it for me. Just don't even try to pronounce it, just spell it. Don't worry about the little characters. I don't have all day to sit here and try to guess what it is you have. Blanderhyden, there we go. That is, okay, so it's a shoe organizer with a cabinet. Okay. Well, now tell me where you are in the process. Okay, what you need to do you have the shelves. There are two sets of shelves. One is bigger than the other. Can you tell a difference in the size? Like, put them side by side. Are you doing it right now? Do it right now. Yes, while I have you on the phone. Okay, the bigger set goes on the bottom. And there will be, you have those two posts and they have the marks on the back. Right, you have to line them up with the corresponding little places where the screws go in. Okay. All right, no. It sounds like you need to flip it over. No, the shelves, honey, the shelves. Not the whole thing. Okay. Now try that. I can hear you. Okay. Oh my God, what was that noise? Holy crap. Okay. No, I understand. Hang up and call 911. All right, great. Thanks. Bye-bye. Some people need supervision. I certainly don't need to be assembling anything. Gonna see if my eBay item has any bits on it. No, dang it. Thank you for choosing IDEA. We swear we thought it was beef. This is Sybil. How may I help you? Yes, ma'am. Yes, we are in the United States. Yes, I understand you don't like calling and then getting somebody in India. I understand. Although, honestly, some of those people speak better English than my callers do. I wasn't referring to you specifically. Okay, so what do you need? I'm assuming you didn't just call chat. The what now? Well, what did you buy that for? Why would you need that? Honey, you can't use it for that. That is not, you cannot use that as a coffee filter. No. Oh, you already did. Okay. I don't know what to tell you about that, except that that is intended for shoe soles, like cleaning. It's you don't use that to filter coffee. I understand that you're trying to be more environmentally friendly or whatever, but no, see, then you get this. People have been known to get diseases only bats get when you do that. You should not ingest this stuff. No, ma'am. No. In fact, there should be a specific warning about that inside the package. Did you look at that? Did you look at any of the material inside? No. Okay, look, don't do it anymore, okay? Okay, and if you start seeing things with your ears or whatever, go to the doctor, okay? All right, great. Thank you. Bye-bye. Thank you for choosing Idea and playing hide and seek in our stores. This is Sybil. How may I help you? Yes, okay. All right, I'll be glad to help you with that. That is actually a very simple one. That's one of our things that doesn't even require any tools. So where are you stuck with that? A Besterold? Honey, no, that's a baby blanket. There's obviously no assembly there. No. Did you mean a Bestaglik? That's the bed frame. That's like the metal frame. Okay. Well, basically, all you have to do with that, because it's very simple, bed frame. No, is this for a full-size bed? A queen size. Okay, doesn't matter. It's the same general thing. You take it out of the box. You know, it's in that long, skinny box. You take it out. And really, the only assembly that there is because it's kind of like an accordion. You just pull it apart, and then it locks into place. Watch your fingers, though, because you can pinch your fingers in those little locks. The only assembly is that there are some plastic little feet that go on the bottom, like that sit on the floor. That's it, and you should have five of those because, you know, you have the centerpiece for support. Okay, now just count them. Can you count to five? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yes, you can. So you should have five of those. I know it's a little confusing. You might think that there's an extra one, but there's actually not. The reason we do that is so you have one in the center for support, right in the middle. Like, especially if you're really fat, it's important to have support in the middle so, like, your bed doesn't sag to the floor. And then it just looks like a sad face, kind of. Like, you take it out and it just looks really sad. Okay. Well, I guess that would be true. Okay, well, great. Well, if you don't have any other questions, yes, thank you very much. Bye-bye. Thank you for choosing Idea, or the reason Allen wrenches exist. This is Sybil. How may I help you? No, I'm sorry, ma'am. You've come through to a very large call center. It's highly unlikely that we actually spoke before. It would be like a million to one shot. Okay, maybe not literally. There aren't a million people here, but I seriously doubt I'm the one you talk to. Okay, well, that doesn't really narrow it down any, because there are like a zillion different southern accents, so just because she had a southern accent doesn't mean it was me. Oh, she had an attitude too? Well, I really find that offensive, ma'am. I understand you don't care, but I still do. So she wanted you to call her back personally if it didn't work. If what didn't work? Like, I can't read your mind. If what didn't work? Okay, so you tried that? Did you turn it upside down and shake it to see if it would come out? And it didn't come out, and she wanted you to call her back. Well, what exactly was she going to do if that didn't work? Is she going to send like a little fairy godmother over there to fix it for you, or? Didn't you try looking on YouTube or something? Because I'd be willing to bet whatever your problem is, there's probably a video on there showing you how to fix it. I mean, wouldn't that be the first logical thing you would do instead of calling somebody a bazillion miles away? What exactly do you expect me to do? I mean, you already called once. And if whoever this person, what was her name? Her name was Clara? Well, my name's not Clara, so it wasn't me. Let me give her a message, okay. Well, no, I understand that. And why should you be mad? You shouldn't be mad. It's not my fault. Okay. I don't think you're being gracious. I think you're being an impatient human being. So you want me to tell Clara? Do you have, like, we have operator numbers that we give out for people that get real snotty and want to talk to our manager. And we have to give out our employee ID numbers. We do not give out last names. Oh, you have that. Ooh, that means something must have happened between you two. Somebody got raunchy, didn't they? Okay. 5, 3, 6, 8, 7, 2. Okay. Well, okay. I'll tell her you called. What's your number? Okay. Well, I'm sure she'll be glad to know that you called her and wanted to talk to her. I'll be sure to tell her. Yes, ma'am. Thank you very much. What? Oh, yeah, I got it right here. These, right, and I am putting that in right now, the updates. I'm about halfway through. Well, if you would stop sending calls to me, I would have been done already. I mean, I can't do everybody's job. I know you think I can, but I really can't do everybody's job around here. Don't get too upset. Your toupee will slide off again. I'm working on it. Okay. Seems like they could have somebody else do this. Thank you for choosing IDEA. We didn't break it. You did. This is Sybil. How may I help you? I understand you hate our furniture. Yes, sir. I hear that all the time. Yes, sir. I understand. But look. Stop. Take a breath. You are hyperventilating. Okay, you have a bag or something you could, like, breathe into. When you buy our furniture, you buy it with the understanding that this is not custom-made, solid wood, expensive stuff. I mean, you know that, right? This is not super fancy furniture. This is furniture that you are assembling at home with little baggies of parts. Okay, this is not stuff that's going to Kensington Palace or anything like that. So, you know, I hate to point out the obvious, but you do get what you pay for. And you chose to pay very little. So you're not going to get, exactly, you see my point? Exactly, and see, that's what you need to remember through this whole process. As you go through the steps, have you even bothered to get the instruction manual out of the box yet? Because I know how men are, and I don't know if it's like a macho thing or what, but... Oh, exactly. You try to put it together without the instructions, and then you get all mad because it doesn't work, and then you take it out on whoever's nearby, and they don't deserve that. And then, after you do that, and then kick your dog, or whatever else it is you could think of to do, you call me, and then you vent to me, and none of us had anything to do with the fact that you just can't be bothered to take the instructions out and look at them. You know, like, take 2 seconds and look at them. Now, I know you can't do that. Of course not. No man can. Oh, some women too. I'm not a sexist. There are women that do it as well. But you men seem to be a little worse about it. Why is that? It's like, you won't ask for directions. You won't look at instructions. What are you trying to prove to the universe when you do this? Well, why didn't you say so? Oh my... The instructions were only in German? For real? Oh, sir, I know you did. Okay, you hold the booklet in your little sausage fingers. Look, take the booklet, flip it over. I'm dead serious. Flip the booklet, the instructions. Flip it over. There you go. Oh, there it is. Now they're in English, aren't they? Yeah. Okay. No, don't feel stupid. It's okay. It happens all the time. Thank you. Bye-bye. feel as stupid as you want to. All you have to do is look at the other side. The screen. I can't decide if it's better with my glasses or without. It's the glare on the screen. These cheap screens. Thank you for choosing IDEA. This is Sybil. What'd you break this time? I'm kidding, sir. Of course you didn't break anything. It did what now? Okay, which one are you talking about? Which set? Okay, I doubt it was the app. Which one? Appler Anishtabar? No, that's a 20-piece flatware set. No, I don't think you mean that. No, of course not. I think you would know what that looks like. Do you mean the Apple Rompress? The Apple Rompress? Does it look like that at all? Just spell it for me. Just spell it and I'll type it, okay? Okay, now that is a pantry cabinet. Like it's a rectangular tall pantry thing, and it has shelves inside and four doors. Okay. So what are you saying broke? What are you saying split? Okay. All right. Well, here's what you need to do. Okay. Listen, no, there's nothing I can do for you right now. All I can do is tell you what you need to do next. Okay. What I do, basically, when you call this number, I'm assuming you got it from the instructions. When you call this number, all I can do is help you with basic assembly help. I mean, that's all I can do. Now, if you have a piece that's broken, oh, it sounds to me like you helped it break a little bit. Because I find it really hard to believe that it did that on its own. Yes, sir, I do. I know anything is possible, but that is highly unlikely because that stuff is made of very, very dense. It's kind of like paperboard. But not really. Right. And some of this stuff is stronger than lumber. So I really think you're full of it right now. No offense, but I think you are so full of crap saying that happened on its own. And no, I think you helped it out like with a boot or an axe or something. Okay. Well, be that as it may, you're going to have to take that up with our replacement department. And I'm going to give you their number. All right. Yes, you're going to have to call them. Okay. All right. Here's the number. Can you write this down? 1-800-IM-ANGRY. And you spell that out. That's right. 1-800-IM-ANGRY. Okay. Now they're going to help you. But if I were you, before I called, I would come up with a better story. Like, I don't know, maybe you can say the box was crushed or something when you got it, and that when you opened it, the door was already split in half. Okay, because if you don't, they're totally going to just boot you. They're going to charge you for another door. And I can tell you now that to buy a replacement for this door is going to cost you $37 plus shipping. And depending on where you are, the shipping could be up to $28, unless you want to go back to one of our warehouses to pick it up, okay? And sometimes it can take 2 weeks for them to deliver to the warehouse, to the retail store. So, unless you want to pay for that, you better come up with a better story than what you just told me, because I'm not buying it at all. Okay? Great. No, sir, I am not in your area, and that is really pervy. What I'm wearing right now is none of your concern, and I have no desire to put on a bikini for you. Okay, great. I'm going to hang up now. Bye-bye. stairs. That's not even right. Thank you for choosing IDEA. Don't laugh, it's another language. This is Sybil. How may I help you? Oh, you got the fire put out. You know, that's wild. You just called me earlier. That's wonderful. All the smoke damage? Honey, I can't help you with that. Do you honestly think that has anything to do with our furniture? No. I don't believe we have anything to help with that. What were you thinking of, actually? No, I don't mean what led up to the fire. I wasn't questioning your logic or whatever. Although I do wonder how you caught the set on fire. I don't even want to know. You want something to help with the smell in your apartment? The smoky smell? Oh, you lose your security deposit. That would suck. Let me see if we have anything for that. Now, I don't know what I can do if you have a hole in your carpet. Now, we do have some rugs. We have some pretty rugs. But see, now, when you move out, that's going to be a problem unless you want to, like, permanently affix the rug to your floor, which I think your landlord is still going to notice that. A beige shag rug. Let me look for the deodorizer first, okay? Because I'm thinking that we do have something. Yeah, we do. It's called Madalden. Now, you can't order here. I don't take orders, okay? I don't, because that's another department's job. It's not my job. No, I don't think I'm going to try to do that. I will, Oh, okay, that's fine. You can go online, but just look up Madalden. Muldalden. Okay, that's a deodorizer. And it's rated pretty high from what I'm seeing here. It is a newer product, but it looks like we have a lot of good reviews. Now for that shag. Now, is it like a light beige or a dark beige? I'm trying to help you because I know how much it sucks to lose its security deposit because of something stupid. I didn't call you stupid. I said this was stupid. Do you think it's not stupid? Because it really is. You caught a furniture kit on fire, okay? I don't even know how that's possible because these things are flame retardant. So you must have had a flamethrower or something. I don't know what you're doing in there. Oh my God, just stop talking, okay? I think it'd be best for both of us if you just stopped talking. And let me work, okay? Let me work. Let me see what I can find here. Now, I have, does it matter if it has a pattern? Oh, God, you're picky. It's gonna be a big old black hole in the middle of your carpet. I think anything would be an improvement. All right, here's one that doesn't have a pattern, and you want it to be kind of a shag. All right. Alingasol. No, I'm not calling you a dirty name. Alingasol. That's what you're going to need. How big is the area on your floor? Holy crap. Are you for real? You know you're going to have to end up replacing all that carpet. In the meantime, the Alingasol should work. It is 8 feet. It's a round shag rug in light beige. Okay? No, I'm not going to order it for you. You're going to have to take some extra steps here to save your butt. I'm not going to do it for you. I'm giving you the name of what you need to order. it's up to you to order that and the deodorizer to fix whatever it is you did. I don't even know. I don't want to know. You're like a, I feel like I'm talking to a future Darwin Award winner. Maybe I am. Oh, you don't know what that is? Look it up. Look it up. You're going to have to go to the website, or you can call our number where you can order by phone. I don't care. Whichever way you want to do it, doesn't affect me. But that will cover it up for now, and you might find some way to fix this without your landlord knowing. I don't know. I mean, that's your problem, honestly, not mine. My name is Sybil. No, I haven't said anything about you. Of course not. Okay. All right. Is there anything else I can help you with? Because it just sounds to me like you're trailing off into something that doesn't even interest me anymore. Okay. All right. Great. Well, good luck and have a nice day. Thank you for choosing IDEA. This is Sybil. How may I help you? Right. Oh my God, I'm so shocked. No, go ahead, go ahead. I'm listening. Yeah? No way. Oh no, I don't hear that all the time. I understand, sir. It's okay. She's going to make you sleep on the couch if you don't finish it tonight. Okay. Well, here's what you do. No, I'm serious. Listen, here's what you do. First of all, get off your high horse, okay? You are not Superman. You are not... Your manhood is not judged by your ability to do this without any help. There is nothing wrong with admitting you need help to lift the box, okay? Now, which one are you working with here? The Gavin Schlegel? Oh, I know that one. Actually, I have that in my kitchen. And it took two big old burly men to bring it into my apartment, okay? Because that box weighs like 200 and some pounds. Well, you need to explain that to her, and you need to understand it yourself, okay? That box is too heavy to be picked up by one person. So what you do, you put your pride aside and you go find a buddy or somebody to help you move that box. And you tell her to shut up because you're trying to get it done and her judgmental attitude doesn't help. Okay? And then, now here's the part that's really going to blow your mind, okay? Once you get it in the house, once you get it in the house, you can open it up, and inside, there's like a cheat sheet in there. I know. It's like taking a test with all the answers. Yeah. I know there are a lot of parts. I know you said you peeked at it while you had it in the back of the truck. I know there are a lot of parts, and it can be scary, but there's like, it's almost like a secret decoder ring. There's a booklet in there. It's these pieces of paper, and they're folded and stapled. And it tells you step by step how to put it together. I know it's the craziest thing. But it will actually help you. And I will bet you anything that if you get that, get your buddy to help you move the box. Because you're just going to end up killing yourself trying to move it. Well, if you have to move it up, definitely if you're doing that, you're going to need some help. Okay? Don't be a hero. And you tell her to just knock it off, okay? Well, tell her to move it then if she can't. Yeah, exactly. Tell her to do it if she knows everything. Now, I don't know why it is that our furniture makes everybody hate each other, but it kind of does. It's like Monopoly. We're like the Monopoly of furniture companies. You know how you play Monopoly with people and you just end up hating each other before you're done? That's kind of what, that's our, that's kind of how we are. Yeah. I know it's awful. It brings out the worst in all of us. But aren't you glad when it's over? You know, you have your lovely whatever and everybody's happy again. So it passes. It's kind of like a thunderstorm in the summer. So, okay. Get your buddy. Take out, they're called instructions. Yeah, a lot of our customers have problems with that. And that's not even some foreign word. I didn't just pull that word out of thin air. They're called instructions. It's an instruction manual. Right. And I have to introduce a lot of our customers to that concept. Look at that burst. Don't automatically call me, okay? Because there's not much I can do from here. You're a bazillion miles away. Okay. Well, you do too. Okay. And you will... Don't be embarrassed, sir. Many of my customers end up in tears. I know a lot of times people are at their wits' end. You don't have to be ashamed. I'm not going to tell anybody. I hear people cry every day. Okay? Well, go blow your nose. Go blow your nose and get some help with that box. Okay? It's going to be all right, I promise. Okay, great. Well, good luck, sir. All right. Bye-bye. No, seriously, it's time for me to take a break. Can I go? I'll come back, I promise. Yes, I am answering the phone with a smile in my voice, I promise. Trouble is, I have a hard time keeping it there. Okay, I'll do better. Yes, I know. Yes, sir. I'll do better. Okay.